Welcome to Airgun TV.
Hello, welcome to Airgun TV. I'm here with Peter Martineau from BSA Guns, and today I've popped in to have a quick chat with Peter. He's got the BSA Scorpion SE with him today, which is just about to be released.
We've released the 177s, the 22s will be available in the next few weeks.
Fantastic.
And in due course there'll be a 2.5 version as well.
It's a superb looking rifle, Peter. Would you like to tell us a little bit about it?
Yep, a quick walkthrough. The major changes between this and the previous Scorpion are the fact that we've changed the hammer system, so it's increased the shot count by about 30%. In 2.2 we're getting around 96 shots, in 177 around about 70 mark.
That's incredible. That's a big game.
It's a big game.
And it's unregulated.
It's an unregulated gun. It's also helped to flatten the power curve slightly. So that's the one change, the first change. The second change is that we now have added a gauge to the gun.
Yeah.
It's something people have asked for. It's now been done.
Brilliant.
The third thing is new woodwork.
Yeah.
It's an ambidextra stock made for us in Italy by Minelli.
Yeah.
Be available in beech, walnut and in a composite. And that is, I think, quite a striking stock.
Yeah, it's lovely. It's lovely.
We've moved away from the checkering that we would normally have to a stipple effect, which I think gives a small, slightly more positive hold.
It does, yeah.
And I think it looks very nice. So those are the major changes.
Fantastic. So this gun's available now?
Yep, the 177s, as I say, the 22s will be out very shortly.
Something that I was amazed at, this rifle is at the same price point as the original Scorpion.
It is. We haven't changed the price at all. The recommended retail remains the same. So this gun in a walnut stock, the recommended retail is $595. In a walnut stock, I think it's $635. And in a tactical stock, it's slightly less. It's, $565.
So it makes it a very attractive option with all the extra bits and bobs, and it certainly looks the part.
It's competitive, it's very competitive, yeah.
Fantastic. I think I might be able to get my hands on one of those. I'll just take this one with me, shall I?
Oh, right, yeah, carry on. We've still got 2 days to run.
Fantastic. Well, thanks very much, Peter.
Pleasure.
I'll be off.
Yeah, right. Bye.
Stop thief.
Thank you. Actually, some other plug we can tackle here.
Welcome to Airgun TV. I'm Malc Barnard. I'm here at the shooting ground, formerly known as Broomhills. I've got the BSA Scorpion SE with me today. I'm going to be taking some pops at targets all the way out to 100 yards with this rifle today. After doing a little bit of homework, I've discovered that this rifle favours the JSB 4.53s. So I guess we'd better get on with it. Let's shoot the gun, see how we go. Okay, first up, you'll see this target's already got a pellet to the right. That was just a sighting shot. I came over about 5 clicks on the scope, and the next 5 shots were at a zeroed 30 yard range. See, the first one is absolutely smack dead center. I've just measured this target, and those of you that have got these at home, this is the SMK paper target. You'll see that this target, the center blue section, is 10 mil, 1 centimeter wide. And you'll see here that all five shots go within that area. There was a little bit of wind, but not really enough to make too much difference. But you can see the BSA Scorpion SE is absolutely chopping the centre of this target out after just a slight correction, after making a little, you know, a small adjustment on the scope. And here we go, this is the fifth shot going through now. Awesome.
Just having a pop at that bell down at 90 yards again.
Oh, with that little one?
Yeah. One more, another mill dot, and I reckon I'll be there. I'm just walking up to it. Just bring the scope up, looks like I've got to come down to the fourth mill dot.
Is that where you
pushed
the front?
Yeah. There she is. You put the darts in the back and then the screw. And then the pick comes on the left. 50 yards is just dragging me about 5 seconds. Well, I was having a lot of fun shooting the bell down there at 100 yards, but I thought I should get on with the review and go over some of the features of the BSA Scorpion SE. I think you've seen without a doubt that this is a supremely accurate rifle. With the JSB 4.53s, it is blisteringly accurate. Anyway, let's take a look at the rifle. One of the things I have done with the BSA Scorpion SE is increase the hammer spring pressure. You'll notice on my rifle, I have the oversized cocking bolt that John Balkit does. This isn't a standard feature on this rifle, but I felt that it gave me some extra purchase when cocking the rifle. The factory setting for the trigger was nice and safe, but I did feel it needed some adjustment, but responded very well and gave a good crisp break. The rifle is shown here with a single shot adapter. I have been using this for all the groups that I've done today and for the 100 yard bell shots, but the magazines do perform well and I didn't notice any real change in accuracy when using them. The filling of the BSA Scorpion SE is as simple as it has ever been. Just simply unscrew the cap, pop in the BSA filler probe into the bottom of the filler port, fill the rifle with air to 232 bar, bleed off the air valve, remove the probe, and then just replace the cap on the end. Incidentally, this cap has been polished, it's not a standard item. To fit a silencer, just remove the barrel cap that I have on here. When you buy this rifle, you get it with a pepper pot air stripper. This reveals a half inch UNF thread, which will take most silencers. Basically, any silencer with a half inch UNF thread will fit this rifle. As you can hear in the background, I'm at a shooting range today. There's lots of noise going on, so I've left the silencer off, and you see me just replacing the barrel cap here. to deploy the safety catch, just pull it back into the S position for safe, and when you're ready to take a shot, push forward for fire. As simple as that. Very robust safety, works very well. To remove and replace the magazine, slide this catch forward, pull out the magazine, fill it with 10 pellets, pop it back in the slot, making sure that it's located properly, and then just return the retainer. Well, there we are. It's the end of a very long day down at the shooting ground, formerly known as Broomhills. I've really enjoyed shooting the BSA Scorpion, and as you might have guessed from the magazine review, I've actually bought this rifle now. This is my own gun. As you've seen in the video there, the rifle is capable of absolutely fantastic accuracy. It was very good with the Day State LIs, and okay with the Air Arms 4.52s, but the best pellet overall was the JSB 4.53s, which was quite a surprise to me. I tried them because I wasn't really happy with the groups out of 45 yards, and all of a sudden the group tightened right up. Absolutely fantastic. I've been hitting the bell down there at 100 yards today with this rifle, with about 5mm dots of holdover. So there we go, that's the BSA Scorpion SE. I'm Malc Barnard. Before I go, I would like to apologise for the delay in the video. I'm sure you're not interested in the reasons why it was delayed, but needless to say, it's been very difficult for me to get this video refilmed after losing all the footage. It was not the fault of Airgun TV or Airgun Shooter, so I'd like to apologise to keep you guys, you know, for keeping you guys waiting for the video part of the review. So there we go. I'm Malc Barnard for Airgun TV, signing off. Bye for now.